Kyron Mears from other jurisdictions, and it was really a beautiful message. And when I got home, amen, I'm going to tell you something. I couldn't find nothing to say. I don't even have a word. Mm-hmm. I looked and I studied, I prayed, and I couldn't get nothing. Amen. But when I came to Sunday school this morning, amen, amen, God gave me a little
He gave
heart.
Us a word.
Y'all hear me?
Yes, He did.
Amen, amen. God, so this is something that I didn't put together myself, y'all. Y'all hear me? Y'all hear me? When we put it together, you know, so Sister Elaine, I might not be as long as I was last week. Praise God. God is a good God. Ain't He a good God? Praise God. And you know what? Our Sunday school lesson was talking about repenting.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. And this is the thing that God really wants His people to be saved.
That's right.
Amen. God wants to bless us so badly, y'all.
Yes, He does.
Y'all hear me? Amen. He wants to give you the desires of your heart.
Yes.
Amen. But let me tell you something. Amen. I believe that God wants us to be worthy to receive everything that He has from Him. Amen. For us. Amen. And when we come to God, amen, you have to realize that God don't want to share you with no other God, with no other thing, with no other person, with no other anything. He wants you all to Himself. Amen. I told him this morning, I said, Sister Spades, amen, I don't want her giving all her love to another man.
That's right.
Yeah, I said that, didn't I say that?
Yes, you did.
And I said, well, where you going? I'm giving you 15 more minutes. You better be back up in here. You know what I mean? Amen. Because God said He's a jealous God.
Yeah.
He don't want to share us with anybody. And that's a lot of love, y'all. That's a lot of love. Praise God. And I'm gonna.
Yes, sir.
I want to read, and part of this was in our lesson, and the other part wasn't. But I want to read from, what was that from? Ezekiel.
All right.
I believe that's the 18th chapter.
Yes, sir.
But I want to read the 30th, 30, 31, and 32 verse.
The scriptures, sir.
Those are the scriptures that I want to read.
Yes.
Praise God. Praise God. Somebody have that? Read that.
Ezekiel 18 and 30 reads, therefore, will I judge you.
Wait a minute. Therefore, will I judge you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That's God. He's going to judge every last one of us. Amen. And He's going to judge us. So in other words, I mean, we've got to prepare ourselves to be right. Amen. I don't mind coming before the judge if I'm right.
That's right.
Amen. If I'm right, I know that when I get through talking to the judge, I'm going to be walking out there with a smile on my face.
That's right.
Amen. And because our God is a just God, He's going to judge us according to our works.
Yeah.
Read.
That's what He said.
Therefore will I judge you.
He said, who's going to judge you?
I.
God is going to judge you. Amen. Not me.
Mm-hmm.
Not your girlfriend, not your husband, not your wife, not your friends, not your family members. God is going to judge you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Because nobody has a heaven or a hell to put you in.
That's right.
Amen. Only God. God can put you in hell. He can kill you and put you in hell.
Yes, He can.
Y'all hear me? Only thing man can do is kill you.
That's right.
But He can't put you in hell or in heaven. Amen, amen. So when folks lay out here, sometimes pastors have to assume because of what folks have told them about folks that they gave their life to the Lord when they was a child. Oh yeah, I'm here.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Well, if you didn't die as a child, amen, you need to give your life to God as you are an adult.
That's right.
Amen. Praise God. And I don't know about y'all, but I give myself to the Lord every day.
Every day.
Every day. Amen. I was in Tinley Park all week long. And when I went to, before I went to bed, I asked the Lord to forgive me.
That's right.
And I don't suspect that being anything wrong, but you never know. I might have crossed somebody one way or another.
Just in case.
And just in case, there ain't nothing wrong with being safe, y'all.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. So I let him know. I said, Lord, I don't know. And now if I've done something wrong, I'm asking you to please forgive me.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Read.
O house of Israel.
O faithful church of God in Christ. Now, y'all the only people that I'm talking to. I'm not talking to nobody else. I'm talking to everybody in this room, even our visitors. Y'all don't mind, do you? Praise God. I'm talking to all of y'all. Amen. That God is going to judge every last one of us. And we, as a people of God, that we're claiming that we want to be God's people, amen, we need to be prepared to be judged.
Amen.
Amen. Ezekiel said, amen, it is time for God's people to repent of all your wrong.
That's right.
Amen. It's time.
It's time.
Praise God. Amen. Read.
Everyone.
Everyone.
According to his ways.
According to your ways. Y'all don't hear me.
Oh yeah.
Amen. If you're envious, if you're jealous, if you're angry, if you're mean, if you're cranky, y'all don't hear me. Amen. If you're evil, amen. You ought to stop rolling your eyes, sucking your teeth, amen. Praise God and learn how to take some stuff. Amen.
Amen.
They told us in the meeting that if you can't take it, you're not gonna make it. Amen, amen. Matter of fact, Bishop Booker said, amen, amen, our trials come to strengthen us.
Amen.
They come to prepare us, amen, to make us stronger, amen, so that when other things come up against us, amen, we should be able to withstand all these fiery darts that the enemy is throwing at us.
Amen.
Amen. Because brothers and sisters, it says the man that built his house upon the foundation, he said, when the rain and the storm came, y'all don't hear me. It stood because it was founded upon a solid foundation. But he said, but the one that builded upon the sand, when the rain and the storm came, y'all don't hear me. Did y'all hear what I said? When?
When?
I didn't say maybe. It is going to come.
It's coming.
It fell.
Uh-huh.
And then it said, great was the fall of it.
Yeah. That's what it says.
That's what it says.
Amen.
Amen. And so, repenting and getting yourself right with God, amen, should be you should do it every day.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Get it right every day. I don't care if you was locked up in the hospital all day long and you were laying on your bed, hey, ain't gonna harm you. Say, Lord, forgive me.
If I did anything, forgive me.
Amen. Forgive me. Praise God.
I'd rather
for us to come up before the Lord, and the Lord said, you didn't have to say forgive me for that today, than for him to say, you should have said forgive me. Y'all don't hear me. Praise God. Nothing wrong with repenting. Read.
Everyone according to his ways.
According to his ways.
Saith the Lord God.
Who said this?
Saith the Lord
God. God said this. Read. Mm-hmm.
Repent.
Repent.
And turn yourself.
And do what?
Turn yourself.
And turn yourself. Amen. When I think about, amen, Bishop Blake preached about the prodigal son. Did y'all hear me?
Yes.
He said the prodigal son, amen, had a conversation with himself. Did he say that? And himself said, listen, we want everything that daddy owes us. We don't want to wait until he died. We want what we're supposed to get, and we want it now. Didn't he say that? And himself, amen, went to the daddy and said, give us the portion of good that falls to us. Amen. And he said, I don't know because that father, amen, was a just man because he didn't have to give him anything.
That's right.
He could have made him wait, amen, until he after he died and he would have got his portion, because he was the youngest son. He wasn't going to get the big portion. The older brother was supposed to get the youngest son. But himself said, we want it all. Y'all heard that commercial. It's my money and I want it.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. But and he gave it to him. Did he do it?
Yeah.
And then he went out and Rabius lived. And he spent it all. Amen. Yeah. And he found himself, amen, feeding the pigs. And then himself started talking to himself. And that's when he realized and came to himself, and he said, in my father's house there are many mansions. He said he's got servants, and they got rings, and they got shoes. And here I am, amen, in the pig's pen, amen, feeding the pigs. And my belly said, and myself said, we need to eat this stuff. Y'all hear me? But the right me said, no, we need to get on our knees and ask for forgiveness. We need to go home. We need to go back and ask God for forgiveness. Y'all hear me? And when he went back to ask for forgiveness, the Father was looking for him. God is always looking for you. There's one thing about it. If you can't find God, God can show him to find you.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. And when the Father looked up and saw him a way off, and then he ran out and kissed him and had a party. Y'all hear me? I'm trying to speed this along. Amen. But it's about forgiveness. God wants us to forgive to ask for forgiveness, because he's a faithful God and he's just and he will forgive you of all sin. Amen. Won't he do it? Praise God. Read.
It said, repent and turn yourselves.
And turn yourselves.
From all your transgressions.
From all of your transgressions. From every evil thing that you've been doing, stop doing it. Amen. Listen, and a lot of times we think that, well, you know, I'm not sleeping around, because they talk about the children, the man was sleeping around. Amen. He was unjust, but we got folks that they don't sleep around. Amen. But they don't study God's word. Amen. They don't pray like they used to. Y'all hear me? They don't come to church on time. Y'all hear me? They don't come to no classes at all. They don't learn nothing at all. They seem like they're riding on what they think they know. Amen. Now you know if they're riding on what they think they know, they're not going to ask God for forgiveness when they've been home all day watching TV. Oh yeah, y'all hear me? Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Amen. But do you not know, the more of God's word gets in you, the more respect you have for God?
Say that again.
Our bishop said, amen, you need to know your God. You need to know him and know what he expects from you. When you know what he expects from you, amen, you're going to be trying to do that.
Amen.
Y'all don't hear me. Amen. Trying to do that. Trying to be there. Trying to be a part of. Amen. Not to sit around and come to service, think somebody's going to entertain you. You come to see who's going to shout, who's going to talk, who's going to take the song, amen, who's going to praise God. Amen. And you sit up there like you're watching a movie.
All right.
Preach.
Amen. The Holy Ghost comes in, and folks are falling all out on the same. You took a
like Johnny Bench.
Y'all don't hear me. Praise God. This is something that if you don't put nothing into it, you ain't gonna get nothing out of it. You gotta put something into it. You gotta clap your hands and you gotta pat your feet. You gotta stand up and give them praise. You gotta listen to them. You gotta thank you. You gotta tell them, yes, Lord.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And if you don't say anything, amen, you're not gonna get anything. Praise God. Amen. You gotta get involved.
Yes, you have.
Amen. Gotta get involved. Amen. I know you're looking cute. Handsome, got on your best suit, got your gaiters on. Y'all don't hear me. Praise God. But you need to put them gaiters up and down. Amen. Roll in that suit. God on here. Sometimes you ladies gonna have to take off your hat and let your wig flow. Y'all don't hear me. Glory to God. Because when God see that you're serious and that your praise means more than what you have on, then when he showers his blessings down upon you and he gives you a true blessing.
Yeah.
Something you can count on. Something you can hang on to.
Yeah.
Amen. God is a good God. Amen. Read.
Repent and turn yourselves from all your transgressions.
Uh-huh.
So iniquity shall not be your ruin.
Y'all don't hear me. Y'all don't want trouble to pull you down. Y'all don't want trouble to ruin you. Y'all don't want sin to ruin you. Let me tell you something, because sin will tear you up.
Yes, he will.
Amen. 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 Sin will kill you. Sin will separate you from the love of God. Sin will destroy you from your family. Sin will pull you out the church. Sin will change your mind.
Yes,
sin
it will
turn you around.
Yes, it will.
Sin will take your smile. Take your testimony. Take your stand.
Yes, it will.
Praise God. You gotta keep sin out of your way.
Keep it out.
Amen. Read.
Cast away from you all your transgressions.
Praise God. You gotta get rid of all your wrongs. Get rid of all your attitudes.
Yes.
Y'all don't hear me. Amen. Amen. If you got an enemy, you ought to go and stop making friends with him.
Yes.
You ought to stop rolling your eyes, amen.
Yes.
Put your hands on your hip and say, I'm gonna give them a piece of my mind, because that's all you got is a piece of mind. Y'all don't hear me. Amen. Praise God. You need to get rid of all your transgressions. And all you gotta do is come to the throne of grace.
Yeah.
Fall down on your knees and say, Father, forgive me. For I have sinned against you.
Yeah.
And I've sinned against my son.
That's right.
Lord, the boy said, Lord, I'm not even worthy to be called your son.
Right.
If you just make me a high person,
yeah.
I'll stand at the door if you just let me in.
Yeah.
You don't have to put me back up into the love, but you can just let me in to the door. Lord, I'll be satisfied.
Hey.
Glory to God.
My God.
The one thing about it, amen, you will be grateful just to get into the door.
Yeah.
You will be grateful. God, just let you hold the door.
Amen.
And you open up the door, just let me hold the door, Lord. Hey.
My God.
Praise God. I got two more verses, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to be done now. One more verse, read.
All right. Whereby ye have transgressed. And make you a new heart.
Listen, where you have done wrong, you come to the throne of grace, and I will make you a new heart. Y'all don't hear me. Amen. I'll give you a heart of flesh. I'll give you a heart of understanding. I'll give you a heart of patience. I'll give you a heart of love. I'll give you a heart that will be able to withstand. I'll give you a heart that will love, that will not quit, a love that will not give up. Hey! I'll straighten you up. I'll fix you up.
Yeah.
I'll make you look better.
Yeah.
Make you look right now.
Yeah. That's right.
I see you in the future, and you look better than you did right now.
Yes.
Got a new heart. With a new mind.
That's right.
He said, be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good.
Yeah.
What is that acceptable?
Yeah.
What is that will of God? A new attitude.
Yes, it does.
Amen. You know how you used to you get angry right away. Now you're able to stand back and think a little bit. Y'all don't hear me. Yeah, I heard somebody say, what would Jesus do?
That's a new spirit.
What would Jesus do? Lord, bless me with that same mind that was in Christ Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Who thought it not robbing, but made himself. Y'all don't hear me. You got to learn to make yourself.
That's right.
Yes, it is.
When you make yourself. Amen. Amen. That means that you're not trying to push them, but you want to put yourself in a position so that God can use you. You're not trying to jump over nobody, but you want to fall back and let God use you. And when God used you, he said, if I exalt you, can't nobody bring you down. But if I bring you down, can't nobody pick you up.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. I'm just about done, Sister Leanne.
One more verse.
Sir. One more verse.
For why will ye die, O house of Israel?
Why would you die not knowing the Lord? Why would you die not having the Lord in your life? Let me tell you something. Amen. Jesus brings life. Sin brings death. It separates you from God. When you're separated from God, there is no life. Y'all don't hear me. The only way you can live is through Jesus.
That's right.
And I said, you know what? You don't have to have a whole lot of money to live. You don't have to be driving the biggest car to live. You don't have to have the biggest house to live. You can be living in a two-bedroom home and still live. You can have just enough money in the bank just to pay your bills. I don't know about you, but every time, amen, I didn't have a dime in my pocket, but all my bills were paid. My rent was paid. Food in the refrigerator. Didn't have a dime in my pocket. If the robber had to come up to me with a gun, he would have to give me some money so that he could take it back from me. My bills were paid. Y'all don't hear me. My insurance was paid. Amen. Food in the refrigerator. Gas in the car. Y'all don't hear me. Amen. You talking about living. Amen. My clothes were clean. Y'all don't hear me. Have soap to wash the dishes. Y'all don't hear me. Praise God. Talking about living. Y'all don't hear me. Now, heaven. God will give you that blessing that adds no sorrow. Read.
For I have no pleasure.
Because he said, I have no pleasure.
In the death of him that dieth.
Y'all don't hear me. God don't have a pleasure in us dying. God don't get no glory out of you being a sinner. God don't get no glory out of you being broke all the time. God don't get no glory out of you not having what you really need. Amen. Because let me tell you something, even if I don't have no money and God is taking care of everything, that's a testimony.
Yeah.
Every once in a while, somebody will come by and shake my hand and put some money in my hand. Do I have any?
Yes, he will. Yeah. Yes, he will.
God will do that. And you know what? He always comes in right on time.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. So why die? Why come to church? Amen. Dead all the time. Come to church dead. Leave the church dead. Because you ain't ready. Because you think you got a lot of time. Why come here, amen, and sit on and watch and look around, amen, don't get involved in the service. You know what? There's one thing I told God, I said this morning, I said, Lord, I know you real.
You know
why I know you real? Because I can feel you. Y'all don't hear me. I know you real. You know why? Because you have touched my body. I know that you're real because when I was hungry, you fed me. Lord, I know that you're real because when I didn't have a job, you gave me a job. Lord, I know that you're real because when I was down and shit like I was out, you picked me up.
When you open the blinded eyes, I was not here. When you heal the sick of all manner of diseases. But God,
oh God,
when you open up my heart,
yes,
when you heal my body,
yes,
when you save my soul,
yes.
I know you're real.
In the death of him that dieth, saith the Lord.
Read.
Wherefore, turn yourselves, and live ye. That's
not
the end of that.
I'm not going to turn you.
You got to turn from that.
I'm not going to turn you. Mama can't turn you.
No.
Daddy can't turn you. But you got to turn yourself.
Yeah, yeah,
you got to come to yourself. You gotta come to yourself. You gotta turn yourself. You can do it. You can do it. I don't believe you. That God will put anything in his body that you cannot do. Praise God. I don't believe you. Sisters, I, the blessing of the Lord makes you rich and it adds no sign. Praise God. I said, you know, I got 155 miles.